Here's one of my favorites. White kids in America who get into Buddhism. These guys make me laugh. I will never forget, you know, and I'm not trying to, like, knock it. On the scale of religions, Buddhism is much less offensive to me than a lot of other stuff, but it's still silly religion. But I just can't ever wipe from my mind the look on my friends' faces when I inform them that the reason that Buddhism has been able to be a religion of peace for about 1,500 years is because they spent about the first 300 years of their existence murderously culling anybody who believed differently. So they don't have to be mean anymore because there's no dissenters left. And I just love it that they have no clue about this. This is such an important part of the history, you know. We casually lost those books. I mean, you know, you look at like these the centuries-old culture in these monasteries. You've got guys who could probably kill you with a touch. You know, martially trained, deadly, completely physically focused. It's all for self-defense, though. You know, it's part of our religion for self-defense. It's Tai Chi. Someone in our audience, I think, was mentioning this the other day about how, you know, Tai Chi just so happens to be a very slow version of kicking someone's butt all over the place. and you know, it's just hilarious to me that since it's different, we're going to immediately assume that it's okay and it's safe. And we're so willing, or people who take on, you know, things like Hinduism or Judaism when it's not part of their culture, when they don't understand the context of it, and they're just like, look at me, I don't have to feel bad for being a big, mean religious person anymore. I'm spiritual.